Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Resurrection Sunday here at the Faith Center. We are so excited today because Jesus is alive.
Yes, he is.
He is alive, and we are celebrating our risen Savior today. And we're so glad that you're logging on to celebrate our Savior with us. What a wonderful day where we can gather for such a great moment to remember that he is alive.
Yes.
And he is well with our hearts. So we are so happy to be in service today. This is going to be a very special day. This service today is going to be very special. So we want to just right at the top of this service tell you to set your expectations.
Absolutely.
Set your expectations for what you're going to receive in this service. And Fred, as we are getting ready to worship, I know we've just been talking about the goodness of God morning and just how blessed we are. So what are you expecting today from the service?
Expecting a lot of friendly faces. I'm expecting a lot of deliverances. I'm expecting a great word. I'm expecting a great worship.
Amen.
And I'm expecting a great atmosphere of love, of peace, of joy, of happiness, of celebration, of all the goodness and goodies and everything that you can possibly feel, Carlene. So I'm alive. Today is going to be amazing.
Yes.
It already is amazing. And I'm ready to go.
We are ready to go. So do us a favor as you're logging on. Welcome to the Faith Experience.
Yes.
If this is your very first time joining us today, what better day for you to join us than on Resurrection
Absolutely.
Sunday. We are so glad that you are here. Take a moment and share this link with someone. Let them know
that
it is really time for them to just log on. You know, your friends who are up early in the morning.
Yeah, we have two services today.
Yes,
and so today is our morning service. We have at 8 a.m. I thank you all. We thank you for logging in early.
Waking up early.
We have social media, YouTube, all the platforms like Carlene just stated. Let your friends and family know if there's any day that they should be a part of the family of Christ and our celebration and why we do what we do and why we stand for what we stand for. This is that day. Share the link with them. They'll be more than overwhelmed. And if you are here in the South Florida area, we encourage you to actually show up here.
Yes.
Sunrise, Florida, Fort Lauderdale at the Faith Center.
Get in the building with us today.
Get in the building. Do you hear me? I want you to feel me now. Come in into the building. It's going to be an amazing time.
It is. And as we're talking as well about, you know, just sharing our expectations, we don't want to leave you out of that. So put in the chat today what you're bringing to the service, how your heart is today, what you're looking to receive from the service today. We want to be able to just engage with you and all of us just worship God together. So thank you all for being here. Thank you for sharing.
Yes.
Now, we are just thankful because we have a great announcement here. So on next Sunday, we're going to be having a guest speaker.
Oh, are we now?
Yes, we are, Fred. Tell them who will be with us next Sunday.
Well, I mean, he's no longer new. He's pretty much like a family member now. Our big brother, our friend, my man, Pastor Joel Tubman.
He will be here next Sunday.
Pastor Joel Tubman will be in the building. If you all have not seen or heard a message from this man, go back on our YouTube. Look at some of the previous messages that he has brought to our sanctuary and been able to just share from his heart. The man is phenomenal. God is really using him, and we are so excited to have him back with us that service. So
We are. Always a good time when he's here in the house.
Absolutely.
And there's one more thing that we want to make sure that you are aware of and that you do not miss out.
What's that?
Now, the year of 2024 is a very special and exciting time for us as a Faith Center family.
That is true.
We are 33 this year.
Let's
the Faith
go.
Center is 33. And our Bishop, Henry Fernandez, is also going to be 60.
It's going down.
The big 6-0. This year he is going to be 60. So you can imagine how excited we are to celebrate with him. So on May 3rd, we all have the opportunity to get together and have this amazing celebration to celebrate his birthday. So here's what you need to do, and you need to do this quick because tickets are going fast.
Yes.
Tickets
Absolutely.
Are going fast. We're going to be celebrating at the Hard Rock Cafe. So get your tickets at henryfernandez.org, thefaithcenterint.org, and make sure that you're there. It is going to be such a fabulous celebration,
friend. I love the word you said, fabulous, because it's a gala. or gala, 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 however you say that. But it's going to be amazing. People are going to be dressing to the
nines. Talk about it.
It's going to be at the Hard Rock. It's going to be a time of your life. If you're there, that's why we are highly encouraging you to show up.
Yes.
Because you don't want to miss this. Like, seriously, if you haven't seen the post, Bish has been doing social media things. Right. He's been doing his little walks and showing us how he's going to dress up and everything.
Real.
The drip is drippy. Do you feel me? So... it's going to be a great time, and we highly encourage you. May 3rd, mark your calendars.
Yes,
really
mark your calendars for that.
Really want you to be there.
Now, we're having fun this morning. It is a great Sunday, and one of the things that we love to do here at the Faith Center is to really show up in the area of giving.
Absolutely.
It is how we worship God,
yes,
and so
yes,
we want to
yes.
make sure that you're aware of all the ways in which you can give. So, Fred, how can we give this morning on Resurrection Sunday?
On this particular morning, Resurrection Sunday, not only this morning, but every Sunday and every day, we have the following platforms that you see on your screen right now, which is PushPay. We have the Zelle platform, TFC's website at thefaithcenterint.org, Dropbox for our local family members and friends who are here on the local grounds. We have a Dropbox right outside of the church for you to drop your donation. Mm-hmm. And for our international viewers, because we are international, what's up, Faith Nation? How you doing? We are here now in PayPal for all of those secure platform that we highly encourage you, and thank you for your donations, for the ones who have been able to help us continue to spread the word and spread the good news of the gospel. Because one of the things we do say here, I love my church.
So I build my church.
And we want to say thank you, continue for your support. And let's go. Because this is an awesome ground to seed
it
into.
It is. It absolutely
an awesome
is.
Ground to seed into, for sure.
And our church is also built on prayer, as
we
know. One of the things that we love to do here at the Faith Center is pray. So as you're logging on this morning, or even for you here on campus, if you are thinking, you know, I really have this thought and this prayer request in my mind, just know that your church family is praying for you.
Absolutely.
We care about you. So if you have a prayer request, you can actually place it in the chat right now. What better Sunday to just believe God for him to do the impossible. So you can
miraculous.
Go ahead and type that in right now. Or if you would like to send an email, you can send it to prayer@thefaithcenterint.org.
Amen.
We care about you. The intercessors will be praying over your needs. Or you can contact a ministry operator at 954-742-7832 for prayer, because that is definitely a big part of who we are and what we do here as a Faith Center family.
Yes, yes.
Now, it is Resurrection Sunday again.
This is it.
We are just so blessed to be here. This is our moment.
This is our time.
This is big for us as believers, a day that we really get together to celebrate what happened on the third day, because He is not there anymore.
Yes.
He is no longer there.
He's
in the grave.
Risen.
He is risen. On Friday, we had an amazing Good Friday service, and we, you know, saw the play that the ministers in training did. It was awesome. And today we are celebrating the next step, which is the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So we want to talk for a brief moment on the topic. He is not there.
He's not there.
So please talk back to us in the chat.
Yes.
For those of you who are here on campus, feel free to just, as we're going through, you know, think about what that means to you, that he is no longer there. So,
there's a scripture
in Matthew 28, verse 16, that we would love to share with you right now, Fred.
Yes. And it states, he is not there. He is not here. Excuse me. He has risen just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Jesus told us, he had prophesied it right before we were already knowing that he was going to be in, you know, we saw him on crucified on Good Friday. He told us before Good Friday that this was going to happen. So the day is that day. It's the third day.
Third day.
And he is alive. He is arisen. He's no longer alive. In the tomb. He's walked out of the grave. Death has no sting.
No sting.
We have the victory because he is alive. Yet and still today.
He is. And you know, he is alive just like he said he would be.
Just like he said he would be.
Just like he said he would be. He kept his promise.
Come on.
He kept his word to us.
Absolutely.
Like you mentioned, it was prophesied by many prophets.
Absolutely.
It was also told by Jesus to the disciples that he is coming back. This has to happen, he said. And he kept his word just like he said he would. And he's still keeping his word today.
Come on.
So he's keeping his word to us in the way that he protects us, in the way that he is faithful to us, because that's the kind of God God that we serve.
Absolutely.
That's the kind of
Amen.
Jesus that we have Amen. On our side.
That's right.
That's the kind of God that we
today.
Have. So today we are
today.
Excited about that. We have a
today.
Great belief. We have a great hope in
yes.
Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And we want to look back at the story of one of this phenomenal woman in the Bible that had an experience that showed her that he was no longer there. So briefly, we want to talk about Mary Magdalene.
Okay. Yes, yes,
let's
yes.
talk about her. A lot okay. of you know this story very well. You know what happened on that day. So this is actually in St. John 20 verses 11 to 18. So we're going to do the pre-show recap version of this story.
Paraphrase.
So here you go. Now, here we have it. You know, Mary Magdalene, of course, we know that she loves Jesus
yes.
with all of her heart,
yes.
soul, mind. And she was there when he died. She was there serving in his ministry. And now
mm-hmm.
that he's been buried,
right?
Right? And not expecting, not knowing what to happen, she
right.
goes to the tomb and she's looking
yes.
for her Savior. She's going there to cry, to
yeah,
worship,
yeah, yeah,
to just be there with him. She
yes.
wants to just be
yeah.
there with
be
him.
There. Absolutely. I love it. And like, she's in a cemetery, a grave site, to where she, again, like Carlene said,
mm-hmm.
to give her heart to just to, like, man, just to be with him.
Yes.
Because I can no longer see him in person, but I just want to be near him to still say that I'm here. Like, I miss you, in a sense. But when she gets there, the tomb is empty. The stone had been rolled away.
Yes.
So, the stone was gone. So, she's here, and her mindset is like, okay, I'm here, but I show up, and what I'm looking for isn't
there. It's not there. He's not there.
He's not there. So it's like if you had a little close loved one or a family member
mm-hmm.
that has passed away and gone, or something that was really close and you lost it or you couldn't find it, and you went to their gravesite and
mm-hmm.
their grave lot was missing, you saw them put them in the ground and it's no longer there, you would be feeling some type of way.
You would be feeling very confused, but we love what happens next. And what happens next is she sees a man. You know, he appears to be maybe the gardener. He's tending
yes.
to, you know, the
field,
area.
The lot.
And
right.
he says to her, woman, who are you looking for?
And why are you crying?
Why are you crying?
What's
going on right now?
Well, what's up?
And she hears that voice.
Come on.
She heard the voice of that man and she says, Rabboni?
Yes.
Is
yes.
it you, my Lord? Oh, my gosh. Can you imagine her seeing her Savior risen? Can you imagine how she felt in that moment? How do you feel
right.
knowing that your Savior is risen? And where is he right now? The Bible tells us that he, according
right.
to Luke 22, verse 16, but from now on, the Son of Man will be seated at the right hand
yes,
of the mighty God. So
right
he is
now,
sitting at the right hand of the Father. And the Bible tells us he's interceding.
Yes.
He is making intercession for us. And that is the hope in which we live today. That our God is risen and that's
yes.
where he is. So we can have the peace that we need.
We can have the joy that we need.
We can have the love that we need.
We can have the hope that we
need. And
we
can have the power
Let's go.
That we need today
Let's go.
Because he is risen. So
Let's
blessed
go.
Be the name of
Hallelujah.
The Lord.
That's awesome.
He is risen. We are so happy today. We're getting ready to go into the faith experience for our Resurrection Sunday.
Yes,
we are
yes,
so blessed
yes.
right now.
And
you're
really,
seeing on your screen the given information of ways in which you can give throughout the service. So thank you all so much for being here. Fred, let's get ready to go into
I'm
the
ready.
Faith experience. You ready for the service?
I'm ready. I don't know. You know what? I am ready.
We
I'm more
ready.
Than ready.
Let's go. Let's go. We're ready to praise God today. Father, we
there.
Thank you for the service. Thank you for everything that's going to happen today. Because you live, we can also live in you. Let's go into the faith experience.
Hallelujah. Come on, somebody, stand to your feet. Stand to your feet. Give God praise. How many know we serve an awesome God? Come on, somebody, we serve an amazing God who deserves to be praised. Hallelujah. We serve a risen Savior.
Hallelujah.
Come on, somebody, give him praise. Give him praise.
Hallelujah.
This is Resurrection Sunday. Thank you today just for another time in your presence, especially a time like this, oh God. You are a risen Savior. Heal like you do. Save like you do. Perform miracles like you do, Jesus, like only you can. We give you honor and we give you praise. Come on, somebody, give him praise. Woo! Yeah. Hey.
great God. He has risen from the dead. There's no other God like Jehovah. Come on and help me worship him in the room. I'm gonna teach you a new song. He shames every idol. He reigns without rival.
deserve all glory, honor, and praise, God. Just continue to worship Him. From the far side of the chasm, you held me in your sight. So you made a way across the great divide. Left behind heaven's throne to build in here inside. Thank you, Jesus, for the
to our service this morning, those of you who are on campus and those of you who are streaming, especially if this is your first time here at the Faith Center. We welcome you to have a faith experience this morning, especially on Resurrection Day. Can we pray? Father, we thank you for who you are and how you have so loved us in such a way that according to your word, You sent your son to die on the cross so that we can once again be reconnected to you. We ask your blessings now upon our worship, our service, what we are about to do. We've come today to celebrate the resurrection of our risen Savior. And Father, we're so grateful that for those of us who are born again believers, that you have transformed our lives. And Father, you've made us to become kings and queens into the kingdom. And for that, we're eternally grateful. As we worship you today, we pray that our worship will be acceptable unto you. We pray that our worship will be contagious, that somehow others who don't know you as Lord and Savior will be impressed and want to come taste and see that you are good. Bless what we are about to do. And we pray that at the end of the day, someone will surrender to you. Someone will say, I need God in my life. Father, I pray that you will heal people even through the worship, even through the presentations and the word today. I pray that you will speak in a great way to your people. And we give you all the praise, the honor, and the glory in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Come on, let's celebrate him one more time. God bless you, and you may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Once again, we're glad you're here, and we pray that you will forward the link of the service, especially those of you streaming, to other people around the world so that they can be a part of today's service. Well, at this time, we're blessed to have our youth ministry. They're going to make some presentations here with us this morning. So would you please put your hands together for our youth pastor, Vaughn Wilson. Come on, show him some love. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Oh, you can do better than that. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
That's what I'm talking. That's TFC right there. I just want to talk a little bit about the skit you're about to see. You know, this is such an amazing day that we get to serve an awesome God that defeated all of our problems, all of our fears, all of our doubts, that we can turn it to the Lord. And you know, there's a spiritual warfare that's going on that's trying to attack our youth. Thoughts of suicide, thoughts of feeling like they don't have a purpose or they're rejected. But I want to tell you and every youth that's watching, that here at TFC, we care about you because we believe, yes, we do. And not only that, the most important is that Jesus cares about you. And there's something about his name, right? That he overcomes all things because greater he is in us than in the world. And right now, I want you to see some of the things that some of our youth are facing, and some of the words, some of the doubts, some of the fear that they're facing. But there's nothing like a love like this, a love like Christ. Thank you.
Thank you. just like a whisper, breaking the silence. You say there's a treasure. You look till you find it. You search to find me. What have I done to deserve love like this? What have I done to deserve love like this?
I just want to take this time, this brief moment that we have, and if you can all stand up for a moment, and you can really take this moment and really, really pray. Maybe it's your son or daughter that you've been praying for, that you've been asking God to touch their heart, to bring them to Him. Pray for our youth. Pray for our youth department. Pray for TFC's youth department. We're making changes, and we're doing things that are bringing more people in because these youth matter. And you know what? You matter too. And your prayers matter. And the service you do here at TFC, you have a place here at TFC. The youth have a place here at TFC. And And that foundation has been set before I even got here, and it allowed me the platform to take that. And I'm just so grateful to God that he placed me here. So if we could just take this time, and I want you to just take this moment in your heart to pray for our youth, because he is mighty. We serve a mighty God. We serve a mighty, mighty God. So if you could just help us worship here in this brief moment, he is mighty. He is mighty.
Here's what's happening around TFC.
Welcome to church. Resurrection Sunday is the celebration of Christ arising from an empty tomb. The moment that the stone was rolled away and it was made clear that death could not hold him, the entire world changed. Resurrection Sunday marked the beginning of a new era, a new day. This Resurrection Sunday, we celebrate a new era for our youth center. We believe in nurturing the mind, body, and souls of every member, especially our youngest ones. Our youth ministry is working to help develop our young people into leaders and believers capable of carrying the faith forward into the future. Thanks to your gracious support, we have begun renovations in the youth center and are implementing new programs so that while you enjoy service in the sanctuary, they can enjoy the same experience on their level. For more information about how to register your child or to volunteer, visit the info desk in the lobby. The University of Fort Lauderdale is enrolling for the summer semester. Take advantage of the opportunity to begin a new thing and resurrect your dreams and ambitions. Visit their table in the lobby or online. Before Christ ascended to heaven, he left every believer with a great commission. Go ye therefore preaching, teaching, and making disciples. Help Bishop Fernandez accomplish this grand task by supporting the Henry Fernandez Podcast. The podcast is designed to reach the unchurched and help them to see that faith in God can help answer any question or solve any problem. It is available wherever you get your podcasts. The Bible teaches that sometime after Resurrection Sunday, the disciples were gathered in one place and on one accord, and the glory of God fell among them. Join us this Wednesday after Resurrection Sunday at 7:30 p.m. for midweek service where we will gather like the disciples in the upper room to study the Word, seek the Lord, laugh, love, and experience God's grace and glory. This is not your grandmother's Bible study. Stop by and check it out or stream it from home. On April 7th, Friend of the Faith Center, Joel Tudman will join us again to sow seeds of wisdom and encouragement into our lives. You want to be in the building. On May 3rd, ladies, pull out your gowns, diamonds, and heels. Gents, put on your tuxedos, bow ties, and patent leather loafers, because we are going to celebrate 60 years of bountiful life and faith for our bishop, Henry Fernandez. Come out and walk the red carpet, mix and mingle, toast to more life. Tickets are available at the box office and online. Get yours today.
Now, back to the service.
He's not. Savior? Anybody glad that they serve a risen Savior, one who is not dead, one who wins every battle, one who fights for his children? The song simply says he never lost a battle.
He is my faithful Father, calling me out of the dark. Darkness can change what the Lord has been said in the light. He is my firm foundation, my anchor won't be. Storms may collide, but my soul is on fire for his word.
This is why.
When listen to the sound of power on my lips, Jesus has broken the curse. He has never lost a battle. Who are you, great mountain, that you should not bow low? Jesus defeated the darkness. He has never lost a battle.
Church, say it.
And he never will, he never will.
He never will, he never will.
And he never will, he never will.
He never will, he never will.
And he never will, he never will.
And he never will, he never will.
And he never will, he never will.
Our great defender.
Yeah.
Our strong tower. He's never lost a battle. No. He's never lost a battle.
Jesus has broken the curse. He has never.
are you?
Who are you, great mountain?
Come on, just think about that thing that's blocking you. Say it again. Who are you, great mountain?
Who are you, great mountain?
That stumbling block that kept trying to keep you back from what destiny God has called you to do. Who are you?
Who are you, great mountain?
I need someone with boldness to just look at it straight in the face. Do you know my God?
He has never lost a battle.
Amen. Would you please stand for a moment as we get into the message this morning? Once again, I'm grateful for all of you who are here today worshiping the Lord with us, whether you're on campus or you're watching virtually. Let me just remind you of a couple of things. One, I will reserve the collection of the offering at the end of the sermon, so please be patient with us. Once I conclude the sermon, if you can remain in your seats and allow us to receive the offering. And when you get into the parking lot, it's so important that you follow the instructions of the parking lot attendants, right? So that we don't have to have a resurrection day for somebody that you're going to knock over. Amen. So just be nice to people in the parking lot. We hope that you will pray for the 10 o'clock service this morning. And I'm kind of glad now that I did two services, because you ought to give yourselves a hand for the 8 o'clock service. Amen. There's no way we could fit you and the 10 o'clock worshipers in the same building. So we appreciate you coming this morning, and hopefully that you'll be with us on next Wednesday. If they could bring me my notes, please, I'd appreciate that. Let's just pray. Let's just pray. Father, we thank you for what you're getting ready to do this morning as you're going to speak to us on this very important day on the Christian calendar. May your Holy Spirit minister to us and give us hope. And for that, we'll be eternally grateful. In Jesus' name we pray. And somebody shout, amen. Amen. Now, before you're seated, do me a favor. Would you hug at least three people and tell them, come alive in Jesus? Come on, tell them, come alive in Jesus. Would you do that? Come alive, come alive, come alive. Amen. Amen. And you may be seated. You may be seated. Thank you so much. Thank you. God bless you. Now, that's what I want to talk to you about this morning. Come alive. And come alive in Jesus Christ. The significance of the resurrection extends far beyond celebration. It's more than just coming on Easter Sunday as we know it to celebrate the risen Savior. In fact, the cornerstone of the authenticity of our faith is Jesus Christ. It is the cornerstone of who we are. It's what makes our faith authentic. What we are commemorating today validates our message that we serve a risen Savior who is actively present in the world. The God that we're serving is not dead. He is alive, because we serve a risen Savior, and his presence assures us that he is always near and ready to assist us in times of need. That's what we, the believer, can look forward to, is knowing that we serve this amazing God who is always ever present in the time of need. So I love the words of the song that says, I serve a risen Savior. He's in the world today. I know that he is living. He's not dead. He's living. And whatever men may say, I know people criticize, you know, the God that we serve. You know, it's not real, and this is man-made stuff. But I serve a risen Savior. He's in the world today. I know that he's living. Whatever men may say, I see his hands of mercy. I hear his voice of cheer. Just the time I need him, he's always near. And I don't know if you can connect with that. But just the time we need him, God is always near. Has God ever showed up in your life when you need him? Do I have a witness out there this morning? And then it says, he lives, he lives. Christ Jesus lives today. Now watch this. He walks with me and he talks with me along life's narrow way. Because there are times in life we encounter difficulty, right? And these difficulties sometimes would make us think that we're all alone in the world and no one cares for us. But Jesus is always there. You see, the message that this song is sending is simply this. It says, regardless of the skeptics and those who don't believe that God is ever present in times of trouble, we say to them that there is a risen Savior who lives and walks with us each and every day. The resurrection of Jesus Christ gives us hope amidst our trespasses and our sins. And we have the hope. We have this hope in him that we can find, watch this, a resting place. With all of the restlessness in the world, we can find Jesus Christ, a resting place that we can rest our burdens and our trials. In fact, in Matthew 11, 25, Jesus said these words. He says, come to me, all who are labor and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. That word laden means heavily loaded or weighed down. So if you are weighed down with the issues of life, you can come to Jesus Christ this morning, and I promise you, he will let your load be light if you trust in him. So the resurrection of Jesus also signifies that through God, we can experience a spiritual renewal and vitality in Christ. So today, you may find yourself in a dark place. Yes, you may be faced with hopelessness. And you may be thinking that, okay, there's no hope for me. I don't know what life is going to offer me tomorrow, the next day. But let me reassure you that serving Jesus Christ brings a new level of hope that is unexplainable. I wish I could try to explain to you what God has done in my life. And I know that I'm not the only one here today. We have a cloud of witnesses here today who can tell you there's nobody like our God. He's an amazing God. He can transform your life forever. Do I have a witness out there this morning? Most of you would agree with me when I say your life is due a resurrection. Yes, your life is due a resurrection. This is true because you need to come alive from hopelessness, fear, doubt, and even unfruitfulness. Some of you are walking in fear. Some of you are doubting whether or not you can have a better future, that things can change for the better in your life. Many of you are unproductive, unfruitful. You're not where you used to be or you should be. You're not really the perfect image of who God has created you to be. You have not walked into the righteousness of God. And perhaps you're currently perceiving that your circumstances are irreplaceable, or perhaps you're thinking that your circumstances are unchangeable, irreparable, unchangeable. Things cannot change for you. Maybe you're even believing that you are forever lost without hope of a positive turnaround. But I have good news for you this morning. Because Jesus lives, because Jesus rose from the dead, there's hope in his word today. Let me urge you to take the advantage, to take advantage, if you will, right now of the opportunity to experience a new life in Jesus Christ. I don't know where we get this from, that serving Jesus is boring. Serving God is some crazy stuff that we do, and it's a bunch of just holy rollers or people who just ignorant and brainwashed and so forth. Listen to me. You have to come taste and see that our God is good, that he's real. This is not something that we're making up. You can't just talk about Jesus. You have to experience him. Do I have a witness out there? You have to come and experience him. As stated in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17, Paul wrote these words. He said, therefore, if any man be in Christ, if any man be in Christ, no matter who you are. You see, here's what religion has done. Religion has made it clear that perhaps only certain people can be accepted. Religion has taught us you have to be right, or you have to make your way into their beliefs a certain way. But when it comes to Jesus, if any man come to Christ, in other words, you got to come to him as you are. Don't change your ways. Don't be right or be perfect. Just come to him broken, hopeless. Come to him as you are, and he is the one who can resurrect your life. He's the one who can change your life. So the Apostle Paul introduced to us a transformative concept that says a life renewed in Jesus Christ offers a fresh perspective that a new way of living is possible. It's possible. I am excited about my faith journey as I was when I got saved at the age of 10. I'm still in love with this amazing God, this God who is so forever loving and caring. He's a provider. I don't know which God you're serving, but I am alive in Jesus Christ. Every day he gives me new mercies. Every day. Every day when you wake up, it's an opportunity to live out your purpose in life. That's the life that Jesus offers you and me. So listen, you don't have to live life depressed. Hello, everybody. Let me just share it with the world. You do not have to live life with depression. Come alive in Jesus Christ. He has to offer you life. Come alive in him. You don't have to live with depression, feeling lost or feeling lonely or being uncertain about your future. Some of you, I know you're worried about what tomorrow holds for you. You're worried if you're going to make it. Some of you have gotten a bad diagnosis from the doctor. Am I going to make it? Am I going to survive? Some of you are struggling financially. Am I going to survive? Listen, let me tell you something. Let me introduce you to this God who can let you come alive. Listen, for me and for many of us in here today, I'm telling you, just because we look dressed up and we look fine, don't mean we don't have financial struggles at times. We just learn to put our trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart and lean not to your own understanding. And all of your ways acknowledge him. We know according to his word, he shall supply all of our needs. So we go to bed every night, not worrying about tomorrow. If he can take care of the birds of the air, certainly he knows how to take care of his children. That's the hope we have in Jesus Christ. So come alive in Christ. Come alive. And to come alive in him, one must admit that they are bound to sin and disobeying God's laws. You cannot come alive in him thinking you're perfect, thinking that you've got it all together, thinking that you don't need him. And you have to ask him to be Lord of your life. This is not religion. This is a relationship. You literally have to tell him, I am desperately in need of you. I cannot live without you. I cannot breathe without you, because it is in him I live and move and exist. I need you every day of my life. I need your wisdom. I need your guidance. You have to admit to that. You have to admit that you need him in your life. And you have to understand that the real purpose of Jesus coming to the earth was all about reconnecting us to the original state, the original will of God for our lives. Remember John 3:16, it tells us, for God, listen to what this is saying. This is the greatest love letter. This is the greatest love letter, the greatest statement man will ever know. He says, for I so love the world that he gave his only son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. He didn't love us when we were perfect. That is why I think the world has really screwed up this word love. We only love when we're benefited from it. I love you in reality if you love me. If you don't love me, I may not love you. But according to God, I so love the world that while they were sinners, while they were imperfect and not in my perfect will, I chose to love them. What an incredible love. An incredible love that says, I love the world. He did not say, I love the Pharisees. I love the religious people. Where did we get this from as believers, that God only loves the church people? He says, I love the world, the imperfect people, the people who has turned their backs on me. I love them and was willing to give myself to them, that if they choose me, they don't have to suffer. They don't have to live in depression. They don't have to live with doubt and fear. If they choose me. So if you're unhappy with your life this morning and you're seeking a better way to live, let me offer you the opportunity to experience what I call the faith life. Let me be clear this morning. If you are not living the life that Jesus offers you, you're not living the good life. I don't care how much party you go. I don't care how much liquor you drink. I don't care how much weed you smoke. I don't care how much you think you're living the good life. If it is lived outside of Jesus Christ, you are not living a good life. And perhaps you will disagree with me because you are enjoying the pleasures of the world. Therefore, you have concluded that you are living it big, living it large. Some of you are streaming and you don't think, I don't need this God stuff. Some of you have gotten yourself educated. You've gotten PhDs and doctorates and master's degree. God bless you. You got your bachelor's. Congratulations. And for some reason, before you had all of that, your dependency was on him. But now you kind of got a little bit advanced in life. You think you don't need him. You think you don't need all of this stuff. I'm not talking religion, I'm talking the word. You don't need it. And you're thinking, I don't need all of that. Let me just share with you what Proverbs said in Proverbs 14, verse 12. And I love this. And maybe this will give you a wake-up call. It says, there is a way that seems right to a man. Oh, it seems right. I don't really need all this God stuff in me. I can just live my life. I'm busy. You know, I get 7 days a week and I go and I hustle and I run my business and I work in my profession and I'm doing well. You've got nice clothes and things. I mean, you drive in nice cars. You're living in great homes and that's all wonderful. Nobody's knocking all of that. But I really just don't have time for this God. I'm living it big. I'm coming alive with my own doings. But the man of wisdom says, there's a way that seems right. If you're a parent, you will understand what I'm talking about. How many times we see our children and they act like they know more than you. Talk to me here now. They act like they know more than you. And how many times you're warning your kids, hey, I've been there, done that, got a t-shirt to show for it. Only to find, like in the Bible, the prodigal, when you think you got it all together, only to find out that you will hit rock bottom one day. I don't care who you are, if you're living your life outside of Christ, you're going to hit rock bottom one day. Because you fail to understand that the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. And I oftentimes say this. You better brace yourself for this. You may not like this. I love this because the God that I serve, he's the biggest repo man I know. I got proof of that. The Lord giveth and he takes away. He'll give you stuff, but he'll repossess it. If you act the fool, would you touch your neighbor and say, don't let him repo your stuff, man. He gives life and he takes it away. So don't you think for a moment you're in possession or you own your life. No, there is a way that seems right to a man, but its end is the way of death. That's the word of God. You see, you and I were never meant to go after the path that leads to death. In fact, Jesus said in John 10:10, he says he came that we might have. Here's where you can come alive now. He says he came that we might have life to the full until it overflows. You see, this is why I'm encouraging you today to come alive in Jesus Christ. Regardless of the challenges of life, if you turn to the resurrected Christ, he will cause you to experience life to the full. I'm not telling you you won't have challenges, but you see, this Christ that I'm offering you this morning will cause you to overcome the struggles and the issues of life. And to truly achieve a meaningful and fulfilling life, I encourage you to direct your complete focus towards the individual who has a proven track record of resurrecting the dead. And his name is Jesus. Even before he was raised from the dead, the Bible tells us he walked to the tomb of Lazarus. And he called forth for the dead to come alive. His track record is solid. That no matter how much you are dead in your trespasses and sin, no matter how you are faced with the challenges of life, the giver of life, the resurrected one, can transform your situation. In the face of life's challenges and the relentless efforts of the devil to deceive us, the resurrection serves as a beacon of hope, reminding us that we are not alone in our struggles. We're not alone. So on this resurrection day, I just want to encourage somebody, you're not alone in your struggles. You're not alone. There's a way for you to come alive in him. It's almost like taking an insurance policy out. You know that you potentially is going to be in an accident. You don't know. Possibilities are strong. And you may not be the cause of the accident. That is why in the natural, we have something that is called uninsured motorist insurance policy. Because you may not be at fault. It may be the other person. Some of you have been hit by life, not because it's your fault. It's the fault of people. You once loved people who you gave your heart to, and they damaged your heart. You've lost trust in them. You're not at fault. You made every effort to invest into something, and somehow it didn't work. You're not at fault. You stepped out in faith and you did what you're supposed to do. You've hoped by now that you would have been married, and you've done everything possible. You didn't play with people's hearts, but yet you're still single. And you're questioning God, where are you in my situation? Today, I am telling you, if you put your trust in Jesus Christ, the struggles that you're faced with, he'll bring hope to you. That in the midst of your crisis, in the midst of the crisis that you're in, this resurrected Christ can give you hope, and you can come alive in him, because it is a testament to the power of our faith. Our unwavering faith and our love in Jesus Christ, that despite the obstacles and temptation that may try to distract us, the resurrection of Jesus Christ encourages us to stand firm in our faith and to walk confidently on the path of righteousness. That at the end of the day, no matter what life throws at us, we serve a risen Savior. And he lives in us. So I conclude the sermon today by encouraging you to embrace Jesus Christ as your only hope. Your only hope to seek for in life. Not things, not people, not money. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and things, money, job, lover, whatever you want, they'll come. But it is crazy and risky going after things before you go after God. You can come alive in Jesus Christ if his spirit lives on the inside of you. Here's what Paul stated in Romans. He said these words, and I love it. Romans 8, verse 11. He says, if the spirit, watch this, listen, capture this. If the spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead lives in you, the one who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your human bodies also through his spirit that lives in you. That if the spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead lives in you, if it's a preposition, if it's a choice, he can live in you, or you can live without him. He's not forcing himself on you, but if he lives in you, the Bible says. The one then who raised Jesus from the dead will give you life. Your human body will have life. And I'm not talking of the life that you're breathing, because you can live this natural life, but if you don't have the life of Christ in you, you're hopeless. Absolutely hopeless. This life that I'm talking about, it's not a feeling. This is not feelings. You see, if you're living your faith life based on feelings, oh, I guarantee you, you're going to live this kind of yo-yo kind of Christian walk, because one minute you're going to feel like serving God, and the next minute you're going to feel like, you know what? I'm not going to be bothered with God anymore. But when He is living on the inside of you, your faith don't waver. You'll get up Monday morning and the devil will throw the kitchen and the sink at you, but you still trust in God. You still got your faith in Him. Monday, your kids are acting crazy. You learn to pray for your children, but you know that God's going to turn that situation around. All throughout the week, whatever the devil will throw at you, because the resurrected Christ is living on the inside of you, you don't worry about anything. Let me just invite some of you who have no clue what it is to come alive in Jesus Christ. You do not listen. And we're not putting it on. For some of us, we're not putting it on. It is real. We are not stressed about anything. Why? Because whatever it is, we know the Master has it all under control. He has it all under control. So let me suggest to you today, if you don't have this Jesus living on the inside of you, and every day when you inhale and your heart is beating, if you don't have Him, that when you exhale, that you're not giving Him praise and glory for the day that He has afforded you with. If you're living every day, I don't know if it's 5 years that you have left on this planet. I don't know if it's 10 years. I don't know if it's 20 years. It could be the next 50 years. But there's a scripture I want to remind you. The Word of God tells us, "Behold, I stand at the door and I knock." There's a knocking every day when that heartbeat is counted. He's knocking. Hey, you know your name. Even right now, He's saying, come alive in me. Come alive in me. Because one day, it's going to stop. It's going to stop. It was just yesterday, I had a casket right here in front of these steps, and I did the eulogy for a man. And I reminded the audience that every one of us will experience death. Everybody. We will this mortal body will die. And the real question is, after death comes the judgment. How did you live your life on the earth? Is the crucified Christ and what He did for us, did He do that for nothing? Or will you say this morning, I believe that because of this incredible love of Jesus Christ, that he left the splendor of heaven and came to earth just for me, then I owe it to him to come alive in him. Would you bow your heads, please? Father, I thank you that you have challenged us this morning to come alive in you. That for those of us who are dead in our trespasses and sin, that we just need to fully surrender and turn to you, who's the author and the finisher of our faith. That we should refuse to live another day without you, because our hearts will stop beating one day. And then we have to answer to you on that day that is called Judgment Day. On this resurrection day, over 2,000 years ago, when your son Jesus Christ came to earth, he lived for 33 and a half years, and it was a day like this, early that morning, the stone was removed from the tomb. And our Savior, the one who paid the price, walked out of that grave, giving us hope that we can come alive in him. I pray for those who don't know you as Lord and Savior today, whether they're here or streaming, that they'll find hope in you, that they will answer to you and accept you before it's too late. I pray that they will see that their ways may seem right, but it's going to lead to eternal death. And that's not your purpose for their lives. You want them to have life to the full until it overflows. So I pray for them today. I pray for those of us who are believers that will not quit our faith, that we will stand strong and believe in your word. Touch and anoint your people today. And even as we give our seed this morning, our offerings, that all of us, whether we're here and those who are watching, that we will understand that a part of our faith journey is to sow into the kingdom. Sow into the kingdom. God, you've done so much for us. And all you ask of us is each week to remember you. So we honor you. We support your work so that others can hear this message of hope, so that the church can be effective in the fivefold ministry, can edify and mature the church. So I pray for those who will choose this morning to come alive in the area of giving, that they will give and they will sow their best seed. They will give according to how you will be pleased. And we give you praise for it. Before you open your eyes, I just want to invite those of you who don't know the Lord as your Savior to say this sinner's prayer. The Bible says you confess with your mouth, you believe in your heart, then you're born again. After that, continue to go to church. I welcome you here at the Faith Center. Read your Bible every day. Stay away from toxic people and environments and grow into the Word of God. Would you repeat these words after me? Say, Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. I embrace the free gift of salvation. And I declare today that I'm born again. In Jesus' name, amen. Can you welcome those people who just confessed the Lord into the kingdom? Come on, let's celebrate them this morning. Amen. Quickly, the ushers have put out the containers. Those of you who are given using the offering envelopes in the pockets of your chairs, please go ahead and pull one out. Complete them quickly, quickly, quickly. And complete it by giving, whether it's credit card or your cash offering or your checks, the envelope has the information there. Would you do that? On the screen, there are several ways you can give if you're given digitally. Would you be so kind to do that right now? Everybody, go ahead now. and give your best seed and watch the Lord bless you. Just remain in your seat if you can, so that way we don't have to have the ushers kind of been interrupted in the aisles trying to do their job. Amen. All right, would you pass the containers around, and the Lord bless you. Everybody look on the screen if you're in the building, those of you who are streaming, and go ahead and text to give right now. You can Zelle your offerings. You can use PayPal or the faithcenterint.org. Many of you are watching. You can call that number, 954-742-7832. And the Lord bless you. And a ministry operator is standing by ready to receive your call. And you can sow your seed. Amen. Let's receive the containers. It's been a great day today. We're about to go into the next service. Remember, when you're leaving, to follow the instructions of the parking lot attendants. And we appreciate you. We hope to see you this Wednesday in our midweek service. Next Sunday, I hope that you'll be here. Pastor Joel Tudman will be our speaker. All right, did we get all the offering? If you still have your envelope, please raise your hand. We'll come and get it. Ushers, please look around. There's some people there. Pastor containers, send it all the way down. Send it all the way down, please. Send it all the way down. All the way down. Thank you so much. Amen. Just give me 2 minutes, please. Just 2 minutes. Because I still see that we're still trying to receive the offering. I thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you. All right, ushers, would you come down now with those containers? And the Lord bless you. The Lord bless you. Amen. Would you stand, everybody? I think we've got it. Thank you for your patience and your obedience. Really appreciate it. Great bunch of people. God bless you. Amen. Man, it was great to see all of you in the first service today. You ought to give yourselves a hand, man. I'm telling you, man, you are the best. Father, again, we thank you for this great day. As we dismiss the first service, may you go with your people and give them an incredible week. May this be a week of resurrection in every area of their lives. We give you praise for it. And we always declare in this house that faith in our God will move mountains out of our lives. God bless you. I'll see you on Wednesday. Have a great morning. God bless you. Amen. Thank you so much. Ministers and workers, please reset everything for the 10 o'clock service. God bless you.